It is day three of what was supposed to be a strike by the local government workers under their union, Uganda Local Government Workers Union, seeking better pay following a 6th July meeting of the National Executive Board. In Kabarole District, the Deputy Chief Administrative Officer, Alex Chikwaya, says that while they are unhappy with low pay, they still have to abide by the laws.
According to the law, one to have gone on an industrial action should have been a member of the union. But most of our staffs have not been subscribing, they are not considered unionized. And that has had much impact. We have told them about the law and the requirements regarding the early strike. And all of them have refrained from going on down there on the strike.
In turn, the Deputy Chief Administrative Officer for Kumi District, Frederick Chitutu, says that the civil servants there are waiting for the government to fulfill its promise to enhance their salaries instead of joining the current strike.
So we are not on the strike. Our offices are functioning normally, and we have not had, we saw only the postings, and we took it as social media rumors. So for us, we're working normally.
The situation was not any different in Fort Porto City, according to the city clerk Moses Otimong, that says that they were able to speak to the workers and help them understand the implications of going on strike.
So, my staff are working from the divisions and the headquarters. But what we have done was to speak to our people. Since there was already an engagement that was initiated by government to engage with the union, even if there are a few areas where they have not harmonized, it does not necessarily require all the civil servants to lay down their tools.
Asawa Edson Ryonga, the mayor of Fort Porto, has called out the government for its discriminatory salary increment before adding that it is important for workers to look at other means of dialogue other than striking.
Let them revisit our constitution and see what the constitution talks about segregation, either in religion, in tribes, and so forth and so on. Now, if you, the leader, is leading us in that direction, what is going to happen tomorrow when the people also decide to say, okay, since it is our government which has started it, let us also do it the same.
So it has been ongoing.